In this example, we are given that a figure shows a water tank at a constant maintained temperature T naught and a small body of mass small m and a specific heat S at temperature T1. We are also given that T1 is less than T naught. That means if water is at higher temperature, heat will be conducted through this rod towards the smaller body. It is given that a metal rod of length L and cross sectional area A, its cross sectional area given to us is A, with thermal conductivity K is placed between the tank and body to connect these. We are required to find the temperature of body as a function of time. Obviously, as body temperature is less than that of water and heat is being transferred, so body temperature will increase. So, in this situation, very first thing we can write, if body is at temperature T, heat current from tank to body can be given as dq by dt. Here we are just assuming that this rod is having negligible heat capacity and it is always considered to be in a steady state. So here dq by dt can be written as ka t naught minus t by L. As we are given that the temperature of water tank is maintained at T naught. So, here if dq is the heat supplied in a time dt to the body, we can write body temperature will raise from T to T plus dt due to dq supply of heat. So, in this situation by calorimetric relation, we can write dq as ms dt. As dq is the heat supplied and its temperature is raised from T to T plus dt, we substitute it here. This will be ms dt by dt is equals to ka t naught minus t by L. Now, we rearrange the variables. On separating, we'll get dt upon t naught minus t is equals to ka upon ms L dt. Just we have rearranged the variables and if we integrate these expressions on both sides, at initial time 0, body was at temperature T1 and say at a general time T, after time T, body temperature changes to T, then simply on integrating this expression we'll get ln of T0 minus T divided by T0 minus T1 with a negative sign is equals to KAT upon MSL. Now here this negative sign can be taken on other side and we can take the anti-log. This will give us T naught minus T is equals to T naught minus T1 multiplied by e to power minus KAT upon MSL. We further simplify this expression, this will give us T, the body temperature which we are required to find, which is as a function of time. This will be T naught minus T1 e to power minus KAT upon MSL. This is the final expression we are getting, which is the answer to our problem. That is the body temperature as a function of time.